Most people have incorrect assumptions about creativity. They think you either have it or you don't. Many people think new ideas just happen serendipitously. But creativity is not mysterious. Everyone can and should become more creative. A great quote is, "Discovery consists of looking at the same thing as everyone else and thinking something different." Really important to think about that. The main problem with creativity is how your brain operates. The human brain is a self-organizing system that converts incoming information to routine patterns and sequences. These patterns help you navigate the world with the least amount of energy. Routine or autopilot allows us to get through each day with a minimum of thought. The brain likes to conserve energy and quickly move forward. However, the more we do something, the harder it is to find new ways to achieve the same goal. The problem with pattern making is that the brain fills in gaps with close matches, focusing on speed over accuracy. Pattern making is an excellent system to allow you to function throughout the day, but it's not very good for developing new creative ideas. Patterns develop your assumptions and habits so you do not have to relearn everything every day. The brain's designed to make sense of the environment by forming patterns of incoming information. It's not designed to identify new possibilities or form new combinations of unrelated ideas. Habits are important to get us through life. For the majority of what we do not need to be creative. Now, these patterns help us navigate the world around us, but make it difficult to develop new creative ideas. Patterns appear everywhere, even when none are intended. We run into trouble when we detect patterns that are not there. By random chance, apparent trends appear everywhere. Patterns control our thinking and become the rules on which we survive throughout the day. Worse, as we succeed, we become locked into the pattern of success and avoid looking for new opportunities or alternatives. We avoid fixing what seems not broken. And a great quote from Roy Blitzer is, "The only person who likes change is a wet baby." I love that quote. Pattern recognition is vital for human survival and evolution. Millions of years of evolution have allowed us to cope with day-to-day problems to survive. And the brain has evolved to filter out a lot of noise. The brain will even fill in information when patterns are incomplete. Since the earliest times, human brains have taken in information from the environment quickly and seamlessly. The information is processed, it's stored and accessed later to adapt and function within the environment that we live. For example, human ancestors needed to identify dangers on the plains of Africa. When a lion appeared, a tribesman immediately knew this was dangerous and his body went into fight or flight mode. This pattern, seeing a lion in a field equates to danger, did not require deep thinking or analysis. It resulted in fast reaction for survival. Speed was the priority over accuracy. Now, the lion might have killed the tribesman if he had not run away. And if the tribesman confused a tree for a lion and fled, at least he was still alive. A mistake in reasoning was preferable to death. And humans still survive and operate within environments through pattern processing. Patterns are processed and coded within human brains to help make decisions from past experiences and habits. Pattern processing helps you recognize things and survive in your environment. For example, finding food, identifying landmarks, and recognizing friends or enemies. Now, pattern recognition also helps you walk across crowded intersections. It helps you get to work every day and helps you find your car in a crowded parking lot. And these patterns create habits that allow you to get through life without having to really think about everything too much, using the least amount of neural energy. There's no conscious effort to think. You just act and you go about your day. Your brain continuously processes patterns to find easy ways to get things done. Evolution has resulted in a brain built for efficiency, not innovation. The problem with your brain operating on patterns is that it makes creativity difficult. The brain tries to maintain habits and avoids moving outside of known patterns. You need to proactively expand your perspectives to develop new ideas. You must overcome routine and habit to create a new future. Exploring new perspectives lead to new and better ways to create new products, solve problems, and change the world. To improve your creativity and be able to develop new ideas deliberately and systematically, you need to overcome the brain's tendency to stick with what it knows and to take shortcuts and avoid new perspectives. The brain's evolution has really focused mainly on survival, not creativity. Creative thinking takes purposeful effort. Deliberate and systematic creativity tools and techniques will allow you to create new ideas quickly and easily. Now that you understand how your brain prefers patterns to creating new ideas, you will realize the benefit of using systematic tools and techniques and looking at ideation as a formal process instead of just winging it and hoping for a new valuable idea to miraculously appear.